Anna, uno, ciak.
Adesso dove stiamo andando?
De Vigne Pierau, che è una vigna che abbiamo comprato in 2015. Abbiamo i vigneti in almeno 9, anche forse 10 contrade diverse. La zona sud era più per i bianchi, e c'è più pioggia e anche il terreno è molto più sabbioso. Invece la zona di rosso era il versante nord. C'è veramente un clima molto diverso. Loro hanno il mare, invece noi siamo fra le due montagne, Etna e i Nebrodi.
Do I have to walk on my own? Can't Amber come walk with me? Alessandro. This is the old original vineyards that we're here, so it's all pre-phylloxera vines, it's all Albarello, and you know, it's a massive selection of mainly Nerello Mascalese. This is probably the main terrace here of the old vineyard, and there's sort of one over there, and then the rest, there was only one or two vines left, so we decided, you know, it was time to actually rebuild the terraces and clear it and then start to plant it over the past sort of 4 or 5 years. Everything has to be done by hand, which is why many of the newer producers and the bigger producers coming to Etna want to razor everything and have, you know, tractors and everything on rows. But you know, for us, it's really the beauty that we do have the Albarello and you know, the diversity and everything, you know, closely planted. We do biodynamic practices through all of our vineyards. This vineyard has never been treated, so it's never even had sulfur or copper, and we have never given it sulfur and copper. And it is never, we never see Oidium, we never see Peronospora. So for us, the more we are farming this way, the more we're leaving the cycle of the native vegetation to go. We're just finding the vineyard itself is healthier. The beauty of these terraces, if I assume you've worked it out already, is you have to come along them until you find a staircase. And then there will always be a staircase that will take you up to the next level. It's actually quite interesting when, even when it has, you know, when it hasn't rained, is just to see how light and friable the lava is, or the, you know, the soils, how sandy it is. But there's so much rocky material, particularly in this soil. Whereabouts we'll go to, I'll show you some other soils from some of our other vineyards, which is like bright red pomace. Another soil is very black. Another one is almost sort of, you know, greyish sand. So I mean, that's another difference between all the contrada. You know, is reflected definitely in the grapes and the wines you can make.
Siamo arrivati, penso, alla parte più umida della terra, scavando veramente almeno un 20 centimetri buoni. Mm-hmm. Qui già è fresca.
Yes, I mean, here would be the altitude and, you know, the snow. And when Eric was here pruning this, because he pruned all of this by hand himself, he came down to the car and the car, it was -4. And he said he hadn't felt quite so cold for a while. So he was pruning it in an afternoon where, you know, there was snow was, you know, approaching and low, but yeah, it was -4. So we have lots of fruit trees on this property, but, you know, at the moment, the red cherries are main, we've got a red cherry here. And then where our families of bees are, there's some white cherries. So hopefully we've been working in this vineyard for about 8 days, so the white cherries may all be gone because they're the best. We've always looked for something that is isolated because, you know, we wanted not to have sprays from the neighbors to come onto our vineyards that, you know, we haven't treated.
Che cos'è che ti spinge a fare una vita del genere? Perché proprio il vino, il contatto con la vigna?
It's all I've ever done, it's all I've ever known, so since I was 19, so I've just actually about to do my 31st harvest. And why? Because I studied and I'm quite scientific, but I love experimentation, I love gardening, and I love traveling. And I love, you know, despite not wanting to talk, I love talking to people. So for me, wine and having vineyards is a combination of all of that. You get to grow something, you get to create something, you get to experiment, and then you get to share it with people and communicate, and you get to travel. And generally you get to meet fantastic people along the way. And I think wine is such a vehicle that brings music, art, food, culture together. We get people coming every year to do the harvest with us. And it's just such a wonderful party and such a wonderful celebration. And it's, again, a really important time to to bring people to the nature, and there seems to be such a pleasure.
When we first bought the property, we would always come for a picnic with our two little boys. So you can't see it much anymore, but this used to be their cubby house up there, and then we made this swing for, and we were looking for a label for Vigna Peral. This kind of summed up the vineyard for us and had a very personal message to give. So we'll taste the wine, but it's literally this tree with this swing. So this is Vigna Gaspar. So we have two boys. One's called Jules. So when we were in 2010, Jules was born, and that was the first vineyard we bought, is across the road. And when Gaspar came along, we didn't have a vineyard, so he kept saying, "Where's my vineyard?" So exactly. So we planted this in 2014 and 15, and then we decided, of course, we're going to have to call it Vigna Gaspar. With Eric, we don't like to do the traditional Etna thing of expose the bunches completely. We like to leave, you know, quite a substantial covering of the leaves, and then come, you know, 3 weeks before harvest, we'll start to aerate the vineyard and take out the leaves. So now we're over in Vigna Jules. It's about 80, well, it was 80 years old then, so now it's probably about 90 years old. We're just managing to keep it alive. The first few years when we took it, it had been worked chemically, we think, you know, with quite a lot of fertilizer. So really we didn't get great results for about 4 or 5 years. And then suddenly we saw a shift. We saw more vitality come back in. So each time we come through this vineyard, we don't have any rules, you know. You kind of just have to have a feeling and a sensation and trust your judgment.
È perfetta comunque, sta benissimo.
For these old guys, yeah. I mean, you know, you can see, I mean, you know, I love the there's a lot of story that's happened there, and you think the number of hands that have actually come through and pruned this vine over the years. But hey, it's still producing grapes, they're still hanging in there, so we will try and preserve these vineyards as much as possible. First Vino di Anna, it's Eric and I, so it's very much him and I, we're interchangeable, it's a family domain. So welcome, this is our Palmento. Just open the... So we're not exactly sure of the age of this building, but you know, it probably is about 250, maybe 300 years old. So we make the wine the first few years. We actually made it in the top. So we throw it all in there and we will plunge it a few times. We get in there, we foot tread it, and then by bucket, we then take it out and we press it. The press is normally outside of the building. But traditionally, the whole thing happened in here, and the whole thing was by gravity. Yeah. So you'd have the grapes going in the top, the pressings would happen there, the pressings would go beneath your feet, and then once upon a time, there was a canal that actually went under this floor, and by gravity, it went into the winery, where our winery is, into big chestnut barrels. We've always been looking for chestnut, and Eric came across this artisan called Alfredo Sanibal, just out in Lazio, and he has access still to a forest right next to the Vatican, and for me must be one of the last artisan producers. Okay, so this is Vigna Peral, so the vineyard we were at before. So the tree that we saw with the little swing, the boy's swing, how can we reflect exactly, you know, what that vineyard symbolizes to us? And then the idea just came through, you know, that tree and the swing. Hi, welcome to our Palmento.
This is outtakes, we'll put this in the outtakes.
Okay, let's go. So okay, cheers. There we go, cheers. Okay, I'm not paying the dental bill.
No, it's absent of any flavor.
And you'll go to a tasting and sometimes there is, you know, only 50, there might be 50 producers and, you know, maybe there's 4 or 5 girls or women that are there. But for me, it doesn't really matter.
Facciamo stacca. Questa è terribile.
Exactly.
Non la metterò mai. A rallenti lo faccio.
Yes, Eric's Garden of Eden. It was him that found the property. Ah. So we were joking the other day that, you know, we'll scatter some of his ashes there one day with the kids.